Hello, you're very welcome to this week's edition of The Cozy Corner. And tonight we feature some of the very best young musicians from Longford, Westmeath and Cavan. And first up is an All-Ireland medal winner, Barry Connolly. You're very welcome to The Cozy Corner.
Thanks for having me on.
Barry, how did you come to play music?
Well, I suppose I started music when I was pretty young. And I started going to classes in Cavan Town with Martin Donoghue in the Nha Ciotas. And I just started playing and going. I went to Katrina Colvin, a well-known piano player, for tin whistle and piano lessons. And then when I started on the flute, I would have went to all the festivals, all the summer schools, the likes of Willie Clancy and Scoláigse for the best tutors. And I suppose just kept playing in sessions and playing out in public. And
right. I suppose Cavan hosted the All-Ireland FLA for 3 years in a row. Did that have any effect on getting you to start playing music?
It definitely did. Like, I was playing music well before that, but I think when the FLA actually came to Cavan, you're exposed to so much. Like, the best players were there for the 3 years, and you're exposed and you're going to concerts the whole time and the launches of CDs and everything like that. And I suppose that just really inspired everyone to perfect music and practice and play.
And last year in Ennis, you won an All-Ireland medal on the piano.
That's right, I won the 15-18 piano.
Right, and tonight you're playing the flute, and I noticed that you play left-handed.
I do, yeah. I suppose I'm one of those people who the lefties, as we're called. But actually right with my right, but I'm left-handed for some reason.
Right, and the flute, it's quite unusual.
Oh, it's a lovely flute. It's quite a new flute that I have, and it had to be handmade because I'm a left-handed player.
And who made it for you?
Mike Rinder.
Right. So as I mentioned in the introduction, you're one of a trio, the Cavan Bucks, and
that's right.
You recently brought out a beautiful CD. You recorded that a couple of months back.
Yeah.
And you've been playing all over the country. Tell me a little bit about that.
I suppose it was actually this time last year we were in the studio with Fintan McManus recording the album. And since the album came out, we've been all over the country. And in November we went to the trip to Birmingham Tradfest. And we played there with some of the great bands like Dervish and the Michael Rooney and June McCormick duet. And then we were kind of all over the country. Then we were in Temple Bar, Tradfest, Derry Gonnelly, all these places. And then actually last year at the FLA in Ennis, we supported Bioga in the Dome in Ennis, and in front of, I think it was 2,200 people. So that was definitely the biggest gig we've ever done.
Yes, and I was at that concert, and I have to say you really wooed the crowd that night. We might add at this stage that the other two members of the band are...
Well, they're not here, as you can see.
They are Zoran Donoghue, who plays...
Zoran Donoghue's on concertina, and then Ellen Grant on button accordion.
Right. And what's it like, you know, playing at that level? It must be extremely stressful.
Oh, well, it is, but it's enjoyable. Like, at the same time, like when we were all backstage at the Dome in Ennis, and everyone was saying, "God, you must be really nervous." But we weren't, because you know we'd practiced and we were rehearsed, and just when we got up there, you just have to let go and do what you do.
Yes. So for young people watching in tonight that have no idea what's involved, you know, can you tell them a little bit about the commitment that's involved in playing to the level that you're playing at?
I suppose it's really the thing of going out, getting out to concerts and as much as you can. Like, I suppose we'd be on the road an awful lot, going to FLAs, going to Milltown Malbay, and we'd be all full-time my mum's car, going up and down the country.
So there's a lot of parental involvement,
yeah,
as well.
Yeah, definitely.
Yes. So you have another set of tunes for me.
Yeah, I'm going to play two reels. The first one is a John Brady tune called Father Newman's. And then a tune which I got off the brand new Mulcahy Family album called The Missing Reel.
Right.
So okay. I'll give these a go.
Thank you. Thank you. I met up with Tomás Doyle recently. He teaches guitar on Saturday mornings in the Green in Edwardstown. Tomás, you're very welcome to the Cozy Corner.
Thanks very much.
You're a student at Maynooth.
I am, yeah. I'm a first year student at Maynooth, studying geography, history and English.
And what's the trad scene like in Maynooth?
Every Tuesday evening there's trad sessions in Brady's, which is a local pub.
Yes.
It brings out a great crowd and it's great to see young and old out together playing trad music.
Yeah, and it's great to have you in the Cozy Corner tonight.
Thanks very much.
What are you going to sing for me?
I'm going to sing Holes by Passenger.
Okay.
I know a man with nothing in his hands, nothing but a rolling stone. He told me about when his house burned down, he lost everything he owned. He lay asleep for 6 whole weeks, he was gonna ask his mother to choose. But then he woke up with nothing, he said he'd take something. He's got nothing to lose. Now he left a hole in my pocket, a hole in my shirt, a whole lot of trouble, he said. But now the money is gone and his life carries on, and I miss him like a hole in the head of an arm. I know a woman with kids around her ankles and a baby on her lap. She said one day her husband went to get a paper, but he never came back. Mortgage to pay and 4 kids to raise, keeping the wire from the door. She said the wall's just a puppy and the door's double locked, so why you gotta worry me for? Now he left a hole in his heart, a hole in his promise, a hole in the side of my bed. Well now the money's gone and his life carries on, and I miss him like a hole in the head. Well sometimes you can't change and you can't choose, and sometimes it seems you gain less than you lose. Now we've got holes in our hearts, yeah, we've got holes in our lives. Where we've got holes, but we carry on. Now we've got holes in our hearts, yeah, we've got holes in our lives. Well, we've got holes, but we carry on. Say we've got holes in our hearts, we've got holes in our lives. We've got holes, but we carry on. Say we've got holes in our hearts, yeah, we have holes in our lives. Well, we've got holes, but we've carry on.
Bernadette Tyrrell is with me now to tell me a little bit more about Mullingar Harp School. You're very welcome, Bernadette, to the Cozy Corner.
Thank you very much, Anna, for having us.
Can you tell me a little bit about the school?
Yes, the Mullingar Harp School has been in existence for nearly 40 years and was originally founded by Tom Marr. Today, the Mullingar Harp School is increasing in numbers and is going from strength to strength. It is held in Mullingar in the Greville Arms Hotel every Tuesday and Thursday, and we have a wonderful harp teacher by the name of Emer Kenny.
Yes, I know Emer. She's world famous.
That is correct, absolutely. She's a wonderful teacher. We are very privileged to have her.
Yes. And who have you with you tonight?
Tonight we have 4 young harpists. We have to my right, we have Grace, then followed by Hannah, followed by Megan, and finally we have Dermot.
And what are they going to play for us?
Dermot is going to start with a solo and is Eleanor Plunkett, followed then by Bug Brain.
Okay. Thanks very much, Bernadette.
Delighted. Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Welcome back to part two. I have a group of singers who are part of Edgerstown Community Games Under 16 singing group. So maybe if I could begin with you, you might tell me your name, please.
Erin Ross.
Nicola Klein.
Cora Murphy.
Ellie Lynn.
Quiva Crossan. Maeve Brady.
Right, Erin, what are you going to sing for me tonight?
We're going to sing Blarney Roses.
Okay, thank you, girls.
Anybody tell me where the Blarney Roses grow? It may be down in Limerick Town or over in Mayo. It's somewhere in the Emerald Isle, this I want to know. Can anybody tell me where the Blarney Roses grow? 'Twas over in Auld Island near the town of Cushendall. One morn I met a damsel there, the fairest of them all. 'Twas with my young affections on my money she did go. And she told me she belonged to where the Blarney Roses grow. Her cheeks were like the roses, her hair a raven hue. Before that she was done with me, she had me raving too. She left me sorely stranded, not a coin she left, you know. And she told me she belonged to where the Blarney Roses grow. Can anybody tell me where the Blarney Roses grow? It may be down in Limerick Town or over in Mayo. It's somewhere in the Emerald Isle, this I want to know. Can anybody tell me where the Blarney Roses grow? Roses in Killarney and the same in County Clare. But upon my word, there's roses, boys, I can't see anywhere. She blinded me and by the power she left me broke a hole to this damsel that belonged to where the Blarney Roses grow. Can anybody tell me where the Blarney Roses grow? It may be down in Limerick Town or over in Mayo. It's somewhere in the Emerald Isle. I want to know, can anybody tell me where the Blarney Roses grow?
The Under 16 Community Games group from Edgerstown, and with me now are Daniel Brady and his sister Grainne from Milltown in County Cavan, and Milltown is near Killeshandra. You're both very welcome to the Cozy Corner. If I could begin with you, Daniel.
Yeah.
You play a number of instruments.
Yeah.
Tell me what you play.
I play the pipes, the flute, the whistle and a bit of piano.
And so that's a lot of work, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess so, yeah.
Tell me a little bit about the amount of practice that you do.
Well, I'd usually do 45 minutes to an hour on the pipes and whatever I have left after homework and that, I do on the rest.
And who teaches you the pipes?
Port McGovern teaches me the pipes and Ashley McPhillips teaches me the flute and whistle and Ony Donoghue teaches me the piano.
Now, the pipes are a very difficult instrument to play. How did you come to be playing the pipes?
Well, when I was at the FLA, we went to a concert and C. Ross was playing and a piper called James Mahan was playing the pipes, and ever since then I just fell in love with them.
Really?
So, yeah.
And who would be your big influences now?
I'd say Killian Valley, or Seamus Ennis or Leo Rison or some of them.
And tell me a little bit about the other instruments that you play.
Well, I started the flute 2 or 3 years ago. I've been playing the whistle from the very start.
Right. So you have a set of tunes for me. What are you going to play?
So I'm going to play two tunes called Peter Turbot's and The Piper's Picnic. And then Grainne's going to join me for Helvic Head.
Okay.
Which we got from the plane of Brian McNamara.
Right. Thank you. was absolutely beautiful. Gráinne, how old are you?
11.
Only 11. And what age were you when you started playing music?
About 8.
About 8. And you play a number of instruments.
Yeah.
Tell me what you play.
The fiddle and the harp and piano and mandolin.
4 instruments?
Yep.
And how many different teachers have you?
A few. Lisa Ward and Mairead Bogue teaches me the fiddle and Sabina McGovern on the harp and Áine Donoghue on piano and Emer Bogue on mandolin.
That's amazing. So you must put in a lot of time practicing.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about what happens when you come in from school in the evening.
I practice my fiddle and then spend a little bit of time on piano and then harp and mandolin.
And what's your favourite?
The fiddle.
The fiddle.
Yeah.
And I know that you've been on radio many times and you've, haven't you?
Yep.
Tell me a little bit about that.
We were on a programme called Cavan Live and we were on FLA TV and we also were, what else? We were on Martin Donoghue's show.
The Wind That Blows?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, do you know, if you survived Martin Donoghue's programme, you'll survive anything. And I'm just bowled over by your talent. You have another set of tunes to play me out with. What are they?
So the first one is Bunker Hill, and then we're going to go into one called The Scammon Reel.
Okay, so to those of you at home who have been watching tonight, I'm sure, like myself, you're bowled over by the talent of these young people from Cavan. Certainly the future of Irish music is in safe hands. Thank you for watching, and I hope you'll be able to tune in next week for another edition of The Cozy Corner. Thank you. I met up with Tomás Doyle recently. He teaches guitar on Saturday mornings in the Green in Edwardstown. Tomás, you're very welcome to the Cozy Corner.
Thanks very much.
You're a student at Maynooth.
I am, yeah. I'm a first-year student at Maynooth, studying geography, history and English.
And what's the trad scene like in Maynooth?
Every Tuesday evening, there's trad sessions in Brady's, which is a local pub.
Yes.
It brings out a great crowd. And it's great to see young and old out together playing trad music.
Yeah, and it's great to have you in the Cozy Corner tonight.
Thanks very much.
What are you going to sing for me?
I'm going to sing Holes by Passenger.
Okay. Hello, you're very welcome to this week's edition of the Cozy Corner. And tonight we feature some of the very best young musicians from Longford, Westmeath and Cavan. And first up is an All-Ireland medal winner, Barry Connolly. You're very welcome to the Cozy Corner.
Thanks for having me on.
Barry, how did you come to play music?
Well, I suppose I started music when I was pretty young. And I started going to classes in Cavan Town with Martin Donoghue in the Nia Kiltis. And I just started playing and going. I went to Katrina Cullivan, a well-known piano player, for tin whistle and piano lessons. And then when I started on the flute, I would have went to all the festivals, all the summer schools, the likes of Willie Clancy and Scoláigse for the best tutors. And I suppose just kept playing in sessions and playing out in public. And
right. I suppose Cavan hosted the All-Ireland FLA for 3 years in a row. Did that have any effect on getting you to start playing music?
It definitely did. Like, I was playing music well before that, but I think when the FLA actually came to Cavan, you're exposed to so much. Like, the best players were there for the 3 years, and you're exposed and you're going to concerts the whole time and the launches of CDs and everything like that. And I suppose that just really inspired everyone to perfect music and practice and play.
And last year in Ennis, you won an All-Ireland medal on the piano.
That's right, I won the 15-18 piano.
Right, and tonight you're playing the flute, and I noticed that you play left-handed.
I do, yeah. I suppose I'm one of those people who, the lefties as we're called, well, actually right with my right, but I'm left-handed for some reason.
Right, and the flute, it's quite unusual.
It's a lovely flute. It's quite a new flute that I have, and it had to be handmade because I'm a left-handed player.
And who made it for you?
Mike Rinder.
Right. So, as I mentioned in the introduction, you're one of a trio, the Cavan Bucks, and
that's right.
You recently brought out a beautiful CD. You recorded that a couple of months back.
Yeah.
And you've been playing all over the country. Tell me a little bit about that.
I suppose it was actually this time last year we were in the studio with Fintan McManus recording the album. And
I know a woman with kids around her ankles and a baby on her lap. She said one day her husband went to get a paper, but he never came back. Mortgage to pay and 4 kids to raise, keeping the wire from the door. She said the wall's just a puppy and the door's double locked, so why you gotta worry me for? Now he left a hole in his heart, a hole in his promise, a hole in the side of my bed. Well, now the money's gone and his life carries on, and I'm missing like a hole in the head. Well, sometimes you can't change and you can't choose. And sometimes it seems you gain less than you lose. Now we've got holes in our hearts. Yeah, we've got holes in our lives. Where we've got holes, but we carry on. Now we've got holes in our hearts. Yeah, we've got holes in our lives. Well, we've got holes, we've got got holes, but we carry on. Say we've got holes in our hearts, we've got holes in our lives, we've got holes, we've got holes, but we carried on. Say we've got holes in our hearts, yeah, we have holes in our lives. Well, we've got holes, we've got holes, but we've carried on.
Bernadette Tyrrell is with me now to tell me a little bit more about Mullingar Harp School. You're very welcome, Bernadette, to the Cozy Corner.
Thank you very much, Anna, for having us.
Can you tell me a little bit about the school?
Yes, the Mullingar Harp School has been in existence for nearly 40 years and was originally founded by Tom Marr. Today, the Mullingar Harp School is increasing in numbers and is going from strength to strength. It is held in Mullingar in the Greville Arms Hotel every Tuesday and Thursday, and we have a wonderful harp teacher by the name of Emer Kenny.
Yes, I know Emer. She's world famous.
That is correct, absolutely. She's a wonderful teacher. We are very privileged to have her.
Yes. And who have you with you tonight?
Tonight we have four young harpists. We have to my right, we have Grace, then followed by Hannah, followed by Megan, and finally we have Dermot.
And what are they going to play for us?
Dermot is going to start with a solo, and is Eleanor Plunkett, followed then by...
Gráinne's going to join me for Helvic Head.
Okay.
Which we got from the plane of Brian McNamara.
Right. I suppose Cavan hosted the All-Ireland FLA for 3 years in a row. Did that have any effect on getting you to start playing music?
It definitely did. Like, I was playing music well before that, but I think when the FLA came to Cavan, you're exposed to so much. Like the best players were there for the 3 years, and you're exposed and you're going to concerts the whole time and the launches of CDs and everything like that. And I suppose that just really inspired everyone to perfect music and practice and play.
And last year in Ennis, you won an All-Ireland medal on the piano.
That's right, I won the 15-18 piano.
Right. And tonight you're playing the flute. And I noticed that you play left-handed.
I do, yeah. I suppose I'm one of those people who the lefties, as we're called. Well, actually right with my right, but I'm left-handed for some reason.
Right. And the flute, it's quite unusual.
Oh, it's a lovely flute. It's quite a new flute I have, and it had to be handmade because I'm a left-handed player.
And who made it for you?
Mike Rinder.
Right. So, as I mentioned in the introduction, you're one of a trio, the Cavan Box, and
that's right.
You recently brought out a beautiful CD. You recorded that a couple of months back.
Yeah.
And you've been playing all over the country. Tell me a little bit about that.
I suppose it was actually this time last year we were in the studio with Fintan McManus recording the album. And since the album came out, we've been all over the country, and in November we went to the trip to Birmingham Tradfest, and we played there with some of the great bands like Dervish and the Michael Rooney and June McCormick duet. And then we were kind of all over the country. Then we were in Temple Bar Tradfest, Derry Gonnelly, all these places. And then actually last year at the FLA in Ennis, we supported Bioga in the Dome in Ennis, and in front of, I think it was 2,200 people. So that was definitely the biggest gig we've ever done.
Yes, and I was at that concert, and I have to say you really wooed the crowd that night. We might add at this stage that the other two members of the band are...
Well, they're not here, as you can see.
They are Zoran Donoghue, who plays...
Zoran Donoghue's on concertina, and then Ellen Grant on button accordion.
Right. And... what's it like, you know, playing at that level? It must be extremely stressful.
Oh, well, it is, but it's enjoyable. Like at the same time, like when we were all backstage at the Dome in Ennis, and everyone was saying, "God, you must be really nervous." But we were actually weren't, because you know we'd practiced and we were rehearsed, and just when we got up there, you just have to let go and do what you do.
Yes. So for young people watching in tonight that have no idea what's involved.
Thank you.
was absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Gráinne, how old are you?
11.
Only 11. And what age were you when you started playing music?
About 8.
About 8. And you play a number of instruments?
Yeah.
Tell me what you play.
The fiddle and the harp and piano and mandolin.
4 instruments?
Yep.
And how many different teachers have you?
A few. Lisa Ward and Mairead Bogue teaches me the fiddle and Sabina McGovern on the harp and Áine Donoghue on piano and Emer Bogue on mandolin.
That's amazing. So you must put in a lot of time practicing.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about what happens when you come in from school in the evening.
I practice my fiddle and then spend a little bit of time on piano and then harp and mandolin.
And what's your favourite?
The fiddle.
The fiddle.
Yeah.
And I know that you've been on radio many times and haven't you?
Yep.
Tell me a little bit about that.
We were on a programme called Cavan Live and we were on FLA TV and we also were, what else? We were on Martin Donoghue's show.
The Wind That Blows.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, do you know? If you survived Martin Donoghue's programme, you'll survive anything. I'm just bowled over by your talent. You have another set of tunes to play me out with. What are they?
So the first one is Bunker Hill, and then we're going to go into one called The Roscommon Reel.
Okay, so. To those of you at home who have been watching tonight, I'm sure, like myself, you're bowled over by the talent of these young people from Cavan. Certainly the future of Irish music is in safe hands. Thank you for watching, and I hope you'll be able to tune in next week for another edition of The Cozy Corner.
Well, they're not here, as you can see.
They are Zoran Donoghue, who plays?
Zoran Donoghue's on concertina, and then Ellen Grant on button accordion.
Right. And what's it like, you know, playing at that level? It must be extremely stressful.
Oh, well, it is, but it's enjoyable, like, at the same time. Like, when we were all backstage at the Dome in Ennis, and everyone was saying, God, you must be really nervous. But we were actually weren't, because, you know, we'd practiced and we were rehearsed, and it was just when we got up there, you just have to let go and do what you do.
Yes. So for young people watching in tonight that have no idea what's involved, you know, can you tell them a little bit about the commitment that's involved in playing to the level that you're playing at?
I suppose it's really the thing of going out, getting out to concerts and as much as you can. Like, I suppose we'd be on the road an awful lot going to Flas, going to Milltown Malbay, and we'll be full time my mum's car, going up and down the country.
So there's a lot of parental involvement.
Yeah,
as well.
Definitely.
Yes. So you have another set of tunes for me.
Yeah, I'm going to play 2 reels. The first one is a John Brady tune called Father Newman's, and then a tune which I got off the brand new Mulcahy Family album called The Missing Reel.
Right.
So I'll give these a go.
Thank you.